if you could talk about anything on the television, not that's on the television, if you had a slot on the TV,
yeah,
what would you talk about?
People with learning disabilities, because the way things are going with benefits and the rights, because they're not included in what's going on really out there.
Is this something you've had personal experience
yeah.
of?
Yeah, and I'm involved with, because I'm on the National Forum with People with Learning Disabilities, and we just found out that people's benefits are going to change, and they don't have a clue, and there's not any help out there for them, so that's a big worry.
As well as working with people, do you have personal experience of
yeah,
that as well?
Yeah, because I've got a learning disability.
Okay.
So if anyone gives me a form to fill in, it's no good to me.
Where would you go to for assistance, for extra help?
Assistant advice, and there's an organisation called Jackson Cancers, and that is really good for people with disabilities. But the assistant advice and the welfare rights, I think it is, that they're snowed under now. They can't have the time to help us, give us the time that we really need.
I know, so I've got a couple of friends and friends' parents who have unfortunately been subject to this, to all this which is going on. And it's not to benefit anyone.
No,
it's not to benefit the people who need it at all.
No.
Do you feel that there is enough publicity given to this?
No.
To this subject?
No. We had two people come to our group yesterday to talk about the benefits, and they said they've been working with people with disabilities, but what we found out, they've been working with other disabilities but not learning disabilities. They didn't get it that how much time we need to help us fill in forms, and when we said to them is that when they ask us a question, we might answer it in a different way, that they haven't got a clue what we're talking about. And it's scary, because one of my friends who was there, who was in a wheelchair, who couldn't speak, and they didn't even get it, is that how to communicate with someone who can't talk. So to me, it's very scary.
How do you, can you see this getting any better?
Oh no, it's going to get worse. And it's going to get worse, because people are losing the benefits already. And what the government and these people don't understand is that some people are scared to ask for help, or they don't know how to ask for help.
You're made to feel wrong to ask for help as well.
Well, the biggest thing is that it's been on radio and television, is that people who ask for benefits are called scroungers.
Scroungers, yeah.
And again, it's like it's taking that pride away from a person.
Yes.
And because I worked and I got injured in work. So it stopped me from doing the job I love doing, working with kids. But now, because they found out, because you've got a learning disability, you can't fill in forms, then you're not good enough. So again, it's like defining reasons to block you.
I agree.
And to me, it's wrong.
Of course it's wrong.
And so,
but it's always the people who, you know, I don't like to say at the top, because they're at the top, but they're behind the desks and everything, don't want to associate or know what's going on, really.
No, they haven't got a clue.
No,
and it's also is, we've got people from other countries coming into our country who we should be supporting, who've been beaten up and tortured in their own country, come here to be safe and well. And we're not even helping them. So if we're not helping our own, not even helping people from the outside.
Then who are they helping? Yeah. Who are they helping?
Just themselves get richer.
Of course it is.
And it's like us again, we suffer. And I mean, the bankers, what makes me laugh, they're getting big fat profits and bonuses. And again, it's the people down here who suffer. And to me, it's wrong.
So apart from the likes of Jackson and Kander, who I agree with you for so long, they're probably one of the most social solicitors.
Yeah, they are.
They have been for very many years.
Yeah.
Aside from the likes of them, who can you go to? Who do you go to?
It's only them, because other people you've gone to, I haven't, because I've only gone to Jackson Cancer or Welfare Rights. Other friends who've gone to other people, like other solicitors, they've turned around and told them, we can't help you now. If you can pay for it, Anna will do it.
Because they've even cut down on legal aid and things like
everything.
That.
Anna. So again, it's that if a person goes to ask for help, if you haven't got the money, then you're tough. Anna. So again, it's like you're left in lumber. But we've even got young kids who are coming through the system now. The parents have never dealt with social service. They've always dealt with the children's part. They suffer a skater because they didn't realise how much of a battle they've got in front of them. Yes. And there's no one out there to help them. So it's sad, really. I have to admit, when Labour was in power, we had it all. But since Tories have took over and the bankers have cocked it all up, we've gone backwards instead of going forward.
Do you think, I mean, I don't want to get onto a political one.
Yeah.
Right. Well, it's only because you've mentioned it.
Yeah.
But, you know, people will say, well, Labour put them in this position, Labour's put the country in this position, and the Tories are kind of cleaning up the mess that Labour made. So do you think if Labour had been in power, it kind of would have gone on for longer and then we'd still be paying the price?
Then what the way it happened, it goes back to when Margaret Thatcher was in power. She nearly destroyed Liverpool and that. When Labour took over, is that they did make things a lot better. But I don't blame Labour for it. I blame the bankers because they got greedy. And they seen things that way they could make lots of money. So it should be them suffering, not Labour. The Tories, it's like they're back in power. But again, it's like living through Margaret Thatcher's crowd again. And they're back in power. Because she took the milk off the kids. She took some free dinners off kids and that. But it always seems to be Liverpool they hit.
Always.
And that's why I was shocked yesterday that they said they're sorry about the 96 fans who got killed. But I still say, will someone get brought to justice for that?
First of all, what are your views on the biennial?
I think it's a good thing. It brings publicity to the town. Brings international artists to visit here. And it's like a good exchange of ideas and people, I suppose.
Are you involved in any way?
No, not personally. I'm just a nosy parker.
Okay, will you be nosy parkering around some of the exhibitions?
I will be, yes.
Any that have caught your eye at the moment?
I don't even know what's on at the moment. I'm literally just come here and I'll find out today.
Okay. I'm just going to ask you something else, okay? I am going to be quick, but obviously with what happened in the city yesterday.
Oh, right, yeah.
Right? I just want to ask you, what have you got any views or opinions or anything you'd like to say with regards to Hillsborough and the outcome of yesterday's report?
I do, really, because I don't think anyone was quite expecting it to be such a shameful indictment of how appalling that the government and the police had acted 23 years ago. And it's taken a long time for,
shocking,
for that to come
out.
And it's just absolutely, you know, this is meant to be a democracy. And you suddenly think, well, what kind of democracy do we live in?
Yes.
As well? So it's kind of a political thing as well as just, you know, for the grieving, you know, for those who lost their, you know, the kids, the husbands and sons, you know?
Yeah.
So.
Did you feel it around the city yesterday? Did you feel,
I wasn't in town yesterday. I was just at home and I wasn't aware of the news until about 6 o'clock, you see. I was one of those just working away, and I was just and when it came on the news, and the news began to unravel about how bad it was, and the fact that 41 could have possibly have, you know, remained alive, it was just, you know, just think, what kind of country do you live in?
Hang on.
I just want to ask you a quick question. If you had a slot on television, what would you talk about? You talk about anything.
At the moment. Be the Hillsborough, wouldn't it? Number one. All I can say, I'm an Everton supporter, but I can understand where they're all coming from. And when I was listening to the radio, when they're saying they want an apology, I was thinking to myself, you don't want an apology, you want someone to be getting arrested for it, don't they? Mm. That's 100%. Whoever's in charge of the police is the number one culprit. And I think that the bottom of the line just goes straight to him, doesn't it? He's the main person who's in charge. He's the one who's told everyone, he's opened the gates in the first place, let everybody in, and then he's backtracking. So, you know, that's...
And I think even though you just said you're an Everton supporter, it didn't matter, did it? No. Everyone in Liverpool was
That's
all...
it, yeah, we're all the same, aren't we? The whole country, I think. I was listening to the radio, and there was a fella from Manchester on the radio today, and he supports Manchester United, and I was thinking to myself, well, that's nice, isn't it?
Yes.
But, you know, it just makes you sick, doesn't it?
What were your feelings yesterday?
when you hear everything?
Well, I drive around all day, so I've got the radio on all the time. And like I say, you get like cold shivers through your body when you can hear it.
Would you mind telling me a little bit more about it? I'm not from around here. So in your own view, what happened at, is it the Hillsborough?
Yeah.
Give us a...
I think, well, like you say, I'm in my 40s now, so I was younger when it happened, but from the police have opened the gates, let everybody in. So I was saying to one of my mates, if you were in charge of a school, right, and you've got a disco and it holds 100 kids, but you left 400 in, and some of them died because they get squashed, who's to blame? The headmaster for letting everybody in? It's the same as this, isn't it, with the police. The head of the police has let everybody in, and now he's backtracking and putting the blame onto all the Liverpool supporters and all that, saying he bunked in and they were robbing everybody and pissing on everyone. You know, that's bang out of order. But now all the troops come out. He should lose his job, well, if he's still in there, he's definitely going to jail for it. Because if you can get 160 odd people to change the statements, you're asking for trouble. And when I was watching it on the telly, someone said, so then police officers who've changed the statements, if they've arrested someone and they're changing the stories now, well, we found out now. So anyone who they've arrested, they should be take them back to court, because the police officers...
Because they've committed a criminal act.
Yeah,
as well.
So can you trust them after doing that? Well, I wouldn't say so, you know what I mean?
That thing there,
yeah.
That tin box,
yeah.
With the broken pavement there.
Oh, right.
I don't care what they say about it. It is not art. It is just vandalism. It is just a mess.
All right.
That was a nice square before they put that there. And you know that? Well, do you know the story about the Emperor's new clothes?
Some more or less.
Oh yeah. Well,
tell us
yeah.
Anyway. It'll be nice to hear again. Yeah. I want to.
Okay,
yeah.
The
have you got the time to show us to walk down and show us it?
Yeah, fine, yeah.
Yeah, but tell us whatever you want. It's perfect to be, you know, critic people around that they don't agree.
Okay, the Emperor wanted some new clothes. These people said, well, we can make you some new clothes.
Yeah.
And they'll be so good that only people of real refinement, taste, sensibility and intelligence will be able to see them.
Mm-hmm.
And all the Emperor, these clothes, they were so fine. They'll be virtually invisible.
Yeah.
And the Emperor put them on, and all his courtiers, wanting to keep in with him, said, oh yes, blah, blah, marvellous, how wonderful. And all the people who wanted to be in with the courtiers said, oh yes, I can see the art in the style, though the cut is wonderful. And a little child said, the Emperor's got no clothes, he's done nothing, I can see his thingies.
Yeah, right.
And then people realised, and the Emperor realised, that all the people who say, oh, this is wonderful art, it gets people talking, it gets people thinking, this is the shock of the new. It's the same old new stuff all the time. Lack of imagination, lack of thought, that is just a mess. They want to say, oh, it's a lift, it has come through the ground. No, it hasn't, it's just been dumped there. And I hope it hasn't cost Liverpool City one penny, I'm a ratepayer here.
If you had a slot on TV, what would you talk about? What do you think needs putting out there that's not currently covered? Any subject?
Any subject? Mm. Well, personally speaking, it'd be age.
Okay, in what respect?
Exercises, how you can improve your health, you know, things like that. You know.
Do you think that there's an absence of that kind of thing on TV
yes,
at the moment?
Yes, there is.
So if you
it's
want...
all for the... I'm not being funny, but it's all for the young ones, which I don't begrudge that. But I'd like to see a kind of like a show just for, you know, pensioners to do simple exercises and not just... Don't just say walking because you get fed up with walking. Yeah. You know, proper exercises that you can do.
So what kind of exercise would you like to do, or do you do?
Well, I used to teach aerobics. And, of course, when you get older, you just don't do it. I mean, I do certain things, you know, just bends and stuff like that. But there's certain things pensioners can't do. If they've got a bad back, they've got to be taught how to do it properly. you know, if oh, they've got bad legs or something like that. Or even people in wheelchairs, if they sit down, they can actually do exercises.
Do you think there's anywhere at the moment that people, the older people, can go for that kind of know-how?
Well, there is a couple of places, but it's... they don't really treat us like humans. They treat us like really old. So they don't show you the proper stuff. You know, they don't show you... They say, just do a bend, just do this. They don't give you a good exercise.
Isn't it something that you'd think to do yourself, especially if you were used to teach aerobics? Wouldn't you carry on and help older people? Maybe.
Well, I think you have to go through all this rigmarole now, all these forms and stuff. When I did it, you didn't have to. And I used to say to people, if you've got a bad leg, you can't go sideways, you've got to go forward. If you've a bad back, sorry, and if you've got bad legs, don't do this exercise. Otherwise, you end up making them worse.
Okay, so you've got to have that knowledge as
you've
well.
You've got to have all the knowledge, and I think I'm a bit too old to start.
You're never too old.
to start doing all this now, you know.
No, you're still but
I would healthy. I would still go, though. I would still go to a place like that just did for like people over 60, 65.
So you don't think anyone's touching on that?
No. It's all for the youngsters. You know, all the beauty things and everything is for the youngsters, not for the...
I agree with you. You know, you're not the first person who will have said it. So it is, when you get past a certain age, you're almost disregarded.
Oh, you are. I mean, even young ones kind of like just walk through you and you stand there and go, oh, I didn't know I've lost that much weight.
I've disappeared, yeah.
You know, but no. I think that would be a good thing.
Can I quickly ask you, if you had a slot on television, what would you talk about?
Probably music, because that's my main interest.
Okay, what kind of music? Are you in the industry?
Primarily, well, my favourite stuff is rock music, but I like all sorts of stuff as well.
Okay, and do you work in the musical industry, or is it just a hobby?
Well, I play.
You play?
I play.
Do you play a particular instrument?
A keyboard's my main instrument.
Keyboard's your main instrument. And do you have grades? Do you teach yourself?
Yeah, I went to college for 4 or 5 years, but mainly self-taught.
Oh, brilliant.
Where did you go to college?
At the community college. Great place. Well recommended.
Sorry, did you say you're in a band now?
Yeah.
What's your band called?
Quake.
Quake. And you play rock music, I assume?
We play, it's predominantly rock covers.
Brilliant. Any particular famous bands that you cover?
It goes everything from AC/DC to Bon Jovi to Brian Adams. Where I go, not Brian Adams. Where you go, Johnny? Michael Jackson, which you don't get in many rock bands.
That's great.
And then we do an excerpt from War of the Worlds as well, so it goes right across the board.
Do you have a particular favourite song that you cover?
Favourite song that I cover? Not really. I don't think I could really single one out, to be honest with you.
Where do you perform?
Mostly on the Wirral.
That's really good. And are there other topics that you would talk about other than music?
If it was on television, I've not really given it a thought, to be totally honest with you. I mean, it's something I'd like to do, but I don't, you know, I've not really thought what.
Do you have any other general interests other than music that, you know, you're passionate about?
Let me see. Well, I did try drama once, but it was a long time ago.
Oh no, that's great! It's really good.
It was interesting. It opened my eyes to a few things that I wouldn't have necessarily thought would have happened. For example, there were some things that we did in drama where we'd be asked to interpret what you thought a piece meant, and I struggled with that. I really did struggle with that because I thought, well, hang on a minute, whoever's created that piece has created that piece with a purpose behind it. You know, so if I've written a piece of music for, I don't know, like a score for a horror movie, then it's supposed to make you scared. It's supposed to sound scary. It's not for somebody else to come along and say, that sounds like birds tweeting in the trees. No, it doesn't. It's supposed to be scary. No. So I struggle with this personal interpretation of stuff. And so I don't know. I enjoyed the bits of drama that I did, but it was also some odd things about it that didn't
What's your accent?
Right, I'm half English and half Norwegian, so I've got a messed up voice.
That's interesting.
You know, okay, anyone who's over 40 will probably remember this. when you were a kid, you used to go out and play the Sweeney. Yeah. You know, I want to be Bodie, I want to be Doyle, you'll talk like that, mate, innit? Right, right. Me and me mates said that. We wanted to be Starsky and Hutch. Right, so it's like, when you role play and that, you've got to talk with an American accent. You know, hey, Starsky, hey, you jump over that side, I'll get in this side. And it stuck, I think, because everything That's we played was American accents.
So is your accent nothing to do with, like, Norwegian or...?
I don't know. Norwegian is a... Well, my father has been here since 1965, so his accent hasn't been Americanized, if you like, because he's lived here. So whereas now the Europeans are sort of speaking almost with, like, an American... Now, Dad is like, oh, yeah, I speak very much English, but I've been living here for many years. It's the Swedish chef, basically. It's great. Sounds like he's just got off the boat. If you're watching this, Dad, sorry. But my dad's never going to go. Did he serve alcohol in there? If they don't, he's not going to go. You know what? Don't you just love it when you're trying to have an interview with some nice ladies and somebody rings you up on the phone?
Anyway, thank you for your time.
No, it's not. It's me alone telling me that I've now got to get off the piano, but I've got to fail to get a drink. That's what I'm doing down here. I don't know if you've seen Tickle the Ivories.
I have, yes.
And Tickle the Ivories leaves on Sunday, sadly.
Oh. So were you doing a little bit of a session?
Yeah, that's what I've been. I just come up here to get a drink before I go down and have another session.